Greetings, guys. My name is Caylen Wojcik with BE Meyers and Company, and today we're going to be continuing the MAWL instructional series, talking about utilizing the MAWL with a precision weapon system. So there's some considerations that we need to take into account when we're utilizing the MAWL on a precision weapon system and shooting at night. The first thing that we need to take into account with a precision weapon system is available real estate on the rifle itself. As you can see here on this rifle, this is a very typical bolt action precision weapon system, and there's not a whole lot of rail real estate here to mount the MAWL. Traditionally, the MAWL was developed to be utilized in a direct action type environment, taking advantage of the shooter's ergonomics with the non-shooting hand. So that way the shooter can easily operate the native controls with the AB buttons. So utilizing the MAWL in a traditional sense on a precision weapon system is not going to be possible because we have all these other accessories mounting to the rifle, such as clip-on night vision. So we have to be creative in where we put the MAWL on the rifle to utilize the controls and still stay true to the ergonomic design features of the MAWL itself. Some of the considerations that people have used in the past are utilizing sections of rail on, say, gas-operated rifles where you have multiple positions along the forearm to mount the MAWL. Some of those positions will work. However, I've found the most advantageous position to mount the MAWL for a precision weapon system to be utilizing something called a diving board, which on this rifle is a section of Picatinny rail that is located on the forward top cap of the scope mount. This way, this allows me to mount the MAWL up and away from the weapon system, and it allows me to have clear line of sight for all of the MAWL's lasers. So looking at this setup from this configuration, it might make a little bit more sense as to why I prefer the MAWL in this configuration on the diving board. So with my non-shooting hand in a tripod supported position or any other supported position for that matter, the non-shooting hand is going to manipulate all the controls on the optic as well as the tripod or the bipods. It also will manipulate my sling. My shooting hand is always going to maintain fire control, so that way I can operate the rifle when I need to. In this position right here, my hand can operate the MAWL very, very comfortably, utilizing the A and B buttons, as well as give me the opportunity to manipulate my optic for elevation, magnification, parallax, and reticle illumination if I need to. When we're mounting the MAWL on a diving board configuration, currently my MAWL is set up for a traditional left-handed shooter. Now, the reason that I have this MAWL in this configuration is I have a secondary aiming device, which is a loophole Delta Point Pro, set at an offset 45 degree angle on the right-hand side of the scope. The reason that I have the MAWL located in this position is so that it doesn't interfere with the use of my Delta Point Pro, and I can still utilize the controls from my non-shooting hand on the MAWL's AB buttons if I want to use the native controls of the MAWL. Some shooters would like to utilize a remote switch, like this one from Unity TNVC, at which point in time you can mount that switch on the buttstock of the rifle and still operate that control using your non-shooting hand. And then we also still have the ability to come back to the native controls utilizing your non-shooting hand for the AB button. I hope that this instructional series is able to give you guys with precision rifles some additional thought process on how to mount the MAWL to best suit your applications. If you'd like to learn more about the MAWL instructional series, head on over to BE Meyers YouTube channel or cruise on over to bemeyers.com.